Good morning to all. How are you? Okay, you are fine. Okay. Children, have you learned the self-introduction? Okay. Students, today let's learn some grammar. Are you ready? Yes. In previous classes, in standard 1 and 2, we had learned statement and questions. Okay children, what is statement? What is a statement? Yes, see, this is a boy. That's a statement. This is my father. That's a statement. I'm going to church. That's a statement. I'm going to temple. That's a statement. See, each statement starts with capital letter and it ends with full stop. Okay? What are questions? Some of the questions are very familiar to us. Okay, what's your name? How old are you? Where are you going? Why don't you learn? So these questions are very familiar to us. See, how can we identify, is it a question? Yeah, no doubt. Each question ends with question mark. Okay? So children, these things we have already learned in previous classes. Today, in this class, we are going to learn how to make a question from a statement. Once again, how to make a question from a statement. Statement, I already told you. See, the sentence ends with full stop is a statement. For example, I will write one sentence here. The rose is beautiful. Okay, the rose is beautiful. See, this is a statement. The sentence starts with a capital letter and it ends with a full stop. Okay, let me write another sentence here. Is the rose beautiful? See, now I wrote, is the rose beautiful? Now it's not a statement, now it became a question. See children, just you see how I made it as a question. So very simple. See, I took the piece out. Okay? Then piece, the rose, beautiful. I took is out. Children, we know what are is, are, was, where, will, have, has, all this. These words are helping verbs. Helping verbs. Say once again. Is, are, and or. Past forms was, were, then will, has, have, see, etc. These words are called helping verbs. Okay, that we will learn later. Then coming classes, you will learn in detail. Okay, what I do right now, just take is out and rest of the sentence. See, is the rose beautiful? Now I got a question from a statement. Children, this is very simple. How to make a question from a statement? By changing the order of the words, we can make a question from a statement. Okay, children, I think you have textbook with you. Okay, you have textbook with you. Just you can see in your textbook in page number 3, we can make a question from a statement by changing the words order. By changing the order of the words, we can make questions. Okay, children, example is given. The one is done for you. The rose is beautiful. This is a statement. Then by changing the position of the words, helping verbs, by changing the order of the words, I ask a question. Okay, is the rose beautiful? Is the rose beautiful? Okay, children, let me say once again, by changing the order of the words, we can form a question. Okay, we can form a question from a statement. Clear? Okay, let's move to the another example. It is raining. It is rain. Okay, children, this is a statement. It is rain. Okay, just try to make it as a question. Okay, very nice. Just take the is out. Then this is, the first letter of is should be in capital letter. Is it? Yes. Is it raining? Is it raining? Is it raining? This is a question. So I put question mark. It is raining. This is a statement. Then from this statement, I make a question. Is it raining? Is it raining? Okay. Then another one more example is there in your textbook. They are late. Okay, let me write. They are late. Yeah, this is a statement. They are late. I'm taking the helping verb out. Then are they late? Okay, children, just changing the position of the words, just changing the positions of the word, we can make questions from a statement. Just remember this. Okay, now you can take your textbook, page number 3. One exercise is given here. Let's try to do this. Okay, heading, frame questions by changing the position of the words, underlined. Okay, frame questions. Frame means make questions by changing the position of the words underlined. You can see some of the sentence and statements here. Then one of the word is underlined. Okay. First one, the shop is closed. The shop is closed. Which word is underlined here? Yeah, very good. Is. The shop is closed. Which word is underlined here? Is. Okay. How can we make it as a question? Very simple. Just take the underlined word out. Is the shop closed? Then put question mark. Don't forget. Put question mark. Okay, once again, is the shop closed? Question mark. Now we got a question from a statement. Okay, let's move to the second question. The children are playing. The children are playing. Which word is underlined though? Yeah, are. A-R-E. Are. Okay, just take are out. Are the children playing? Are the children playing? Okay? Don't forget to put question mark. Okay, let's move to the third question. John will win the race. Okay, it's a statement. John will win the race. Okay, underlined word is will. Take the underlined word out. Take the helping verb out. Will John win the race? Will John win the race? Let's move to the fourth question. The dogs were barking in the night. The dogs were barking in the night. Okay, children. The verb is underlined. Just take the verb out. Were the dogs barking in the night? Okay. Next page number 4. Continue the exercise. Exercise number 5. Rina was happy. Rina was happy. Okay, underlined word is was Rina happy? Was Rina happy? Put the question mark. Okay. Sixth one. The farmers were sowing seeds. The farmers were sowing seeds. Word is underlined here. Just take the word out. Were the farmers sowing seeds? Were the farmers sowing seeds? Okay. Seventh one. They are learning a poem. They are learning a poem. Are is underlined. Then are they learning a poem? Okay, children. Rest of the questions you can do yourself. It's very simple. See, lot of examples I already show you. So rest of the questions you have to do yourself. Okay, clear? Understand? Okay. Just think what are the helping words. Is, are, was, were, will, have, has, had. Just how to make a question from a statement. By changing the position of the words, we can change. Okay, we can make question. Then you have to remember one thing. At the end of that each question, we must put question mark. At the end of the each statement, we must put full stop. Okay, clear? Then, questions can also be formed by using question words. Children, we know what are the question words. Some of the questions in the beginning I told you, some of the questions are very few. What is the name of your father? How old are you? Who is your teacher? Where are you going? Why are you late? Okay, some of the questions are very familiar to us. Then most of these words, most of these question words starts with WH. WH. Okay, these question words are called WH questions. Okay, you will learn later in coming classes these things very detailed. Okay, we can make, in this way we can make questions. In another way, by using question words, we can make questions. Some of the question words are given there in exercise number B. There is one box, you can see some question words. Let me read that. First one is where. W-H-E-R-E, where. Next one, who, when, what, why, how, and how many. Okay, do you know the meaning of these question words? Yes, let me say once again. Where means, yeah, evide. Where is your house? Okay, evide yana in the veedu. Where, evide. Then, who means, are you? Who are you? Who is your class teacher? Okay, next one. When? Apple. When? When is your birthday? When do you come? Okay, next one. What? This word is very familiar. What's your name? Endu. What? Endu. Okay, why? Why means? Yeah, endu undu. Why do you late? Why do you late? Okay, how? How? Engane? How? How old are you? Or how do you late? How? Okay, then next, how many? How many? Etra enna? Etra enna? How many members are there in your family? How many members are there in your family? Okay? So some of these question words are given there. Then by using these question words, you can make correct questions. Okay? Some of the sentences are given there. Some of the questions are given there. By using correct question word, you have to fill this. Okay, so exercise B is very easy for you. Just read the question words. Just think the meaning of the each word and take the correct question word and fill the blanks. Okay, children, what you learned today? How to make questions from a statement. Okay, by changing the position of the words, we can make questions. Okay, children, now you have to do this exercise number 3 and 4, page number 3 and 4 in your textbook. Then today itself, you have to read this lesson 5 times. Next day, I will send some of the students' name. Those children just send their exercise, your homework to my personal WhatsApp. Okay? Just revise these things. Yesterday, in the last class, we had learned the self-introduction. Just spent a few time to practice those things. Read the textbook. Okay? Let me conclude today's class. Have a nice day.